Hello viewers, welcome to UN Digital class. In my previous lecture, I have discussed about the authentication function. In authentication function, I have only discussed the first technique, that is the message encryption. Now, in this lecture, I am going to discuss about the second technique, that is message authentication code. In message authentication code, here, this technique assumes that two parties, says A and B, tries to communicating with each other by sharing a secret key, that is K. Suppose here A is the sender and B is the receiver. A wants to send some message to B. For sending message, first of all, here A generates a code. That code is message authentication code or MAC. And this MAC code is generated by using a function that is C. Here this function takes the original message M and the secret key K and generates a code which is called as message authentication code. Now, here this message authentication code act as authenticator. Because in this technique, this MAC is used to authenticate the sender and receiver. But in your previous technique, that is the message encryption. In message encryption, the ciphertext is used as the authenticator. Now, look at the different case. In first case, suppose here is our sender A and here is our receiver B. And the sender wants to send some message to receiver B. That means, suppose the message is M. Here, the sender generates this message which is also called as the plain text. Now, after generating the plain text, the sender calculates the MAC function. That means, here the sender takes this message and calculates the MAC function by using the function C, where this function takes our original message M and a secret key K. Here, the secret key K is shared between the sender and receiver. That means, here only the authenticated sender and receiver knows this key. In your example, this key K is shared between our sender A and receiver B. Other than A and B, no one knows this key. Now, here the function C takes the plain text M and the secret key K and it generates the message authentication code, that is MAC. Now, after generating this code, it appends this MAC code with our plain text. Now, here this MAC code is appended. Here this is the appended. That means this MAC code and the original message is appended. Then, after appending the message with the MAC code, it is transmitted to the receiver B. This is the original message and this is the MAC. When the receiver receives this message, first it takes the original message, that is M. And by taking this message, again it calculates the MAC value by applying the function, that is C, and use the secret key, that is K. After that, it generates the MAC value. Here, this is the MAC value or the message authentication code. After generating this MAC value, now the receiver compares the generated MAC value with the appended MAC value. That means here the receiver compare these two MAC value. If these two MAC value is same, that means the receiver is sure about that there is no alteration in the message. That means this message is received from the authenticated sender. Now, look at here. Here, this is our message which is actually transmitted over the network. If other than A and B, there is some attacker, and that attacker takes this message from the network. When the attacker takes this message from the network, then the attacker takes this original message, that is the plain text, and change this message to other message. Suppose here our plain text is M, and the attacker changes this M to M1. Then it append this M1 with this MAC value and send it to the receiver B. When the receiver receives this message, then it takes this message and again calculated the MAC value. Here, when the receiver takes this message, that means here the message is M1 and calculated the MAC value. Here, the generated MAC value and the appended MAC value are different. Then, the receiver sure that there is some alteration in plain text. That means in this case, the receiver knows if there is any alteration in your message, because the MAC value cannot be changed by the attacker. Suppose the attacker takes this MAC value and wants to change it by using this message, then the attacker must have to know about the secret key K. But here the secret key K is only known to our authenticated sender and receiver. Other than this authenticated sender and receiver, no one knows this key. That means in this case, the attacker does not change the MAC value, so that the receiver can easily identify whether this message is coming from an authenticated sender or not. That means here our message authentication satisfied. Now check for the confidentiality. Confidentiality means our message must be transmitted confidentially, because without the sender and receiver, no one knows this message. But in this case, when our message M is transmitted over the network, then the attacker takes this message easily, because in this message there is no encryption algorithm is used. So that in this case, the confidentiality does not satisfy. Only it satisfies the message authentication. Not satisfied. It satisfies authentication. Now, look at the second case. In second case, the sender also takes one message M, which is also called as the plain text. And here the sender wants to send this message to the receiver B. That means first of all, the sender calculates the MAC value. Now here it used the function C, which takes the secret key value K and the original message M, and generates the MAC value. After generating this MAC value, then it append this MAC value with the original message. After appending these two value, that is the MAC value with the original message, here the sender used some encryption algorithm and key, that is K2. Here this is K1. That means after appending the original message with your MAC value, this appended message is encrypted by using some encryption algorithm and the secret key, that is K2. After that, the encrypted message, that is E of K2, here message and MAC value appended. That means now this message is transmitted over the network. When the receiver receives this encrypted message, first of all it applies the decryption algorithm and the key is K2, because in this case the sender and receiver uses two secret key. One is the K1, another one is the K2. Now applying the decryption algorithm, it generates the appended message, that is the here original message M, and this one is the MAC value. After generating this, the receiver again choose the original message, and by using this original message is calculate the MAC value by applying the function C. Here it takes the secret key K1. After this, it generates the MAC value. Now here this one is the appended MAC value and this one is the generated MAC value. Now the receiver compares these two MAC value. That means here the receiver compare these two MAC value. If these two MAC value are equal, that means the receiver sure that this message is a secure message. There is no alteration in this message. If these two MAC values are different, that means the receiver sure that there is some alteration in original message. Now look at here, this is the message which is actually transmitted over the network. When this message is transmitted over the network, suppose there is some attacker and the attacker takes this message and wants to generate the plain text from this message. For generating plain text or generating the original message from this message, the attacker must have to know about the secret key, that is K2, because here this is our encrypted message. To decrypt this message, the attacker must have to know about the secret key, that is K2. But here the secret key K2 is only known to our sender A and receiver B. That means the attacker cannot decrypt this message, so that this case satisfies the confidentiality. Now check for the authentication. Here the authentication is tied to our plain text because the MAC function is calculated from our plain text. So here the authentication tied to plain text. This MAC function acts as a authenticator, and this authenticator is used in our plain text, so that in this case the authentication is tied to our plain text. This case satisfies two security goals. One is the confidentiality, another one is the authenticity. Now look at the next case. Here the sender choose one message, that is M. Now by choosing this message, the sender wants to send this message to the receiver B. In this case, the sender first encrypt this message by using some secret key, that key is the K2. After encrypting this message, then the sender used the encrypted message to generate the MAC function. Here this is our MAC function which takes the encrypted message and another secret key, that is K1. After generating the MAC function, then the sender append this MAC function with our encrypted message. Now here the encrypted message is appended with our MAC value. After appending, the message is transmitted over the network. Here this is our encrypted message and this is our MAC value. Now when the receiver receives this value, first the receiver applies the decryption algorithm. Here use any decryption algorithm and the secret key is K2, because here for encryption the sender used the secret key K2, so that for decryption the receiver also used the same key, that is K2, for decrypting this message. Now after decrypting this message, it generates the original message, that is M. Again here the receiver also takes this message, encrypted message, to calculate the MAC value. Here for calculating the MAC value, it uses the another secret key, that is K1. Then it generates the MAC value. Now look at here. Here this one is the generated MAC value by the receiver B, and this one is the appended MAC value which is transmitted from the sender A. Now these two MAC values compared. When the receiver compare these two MAC value, if these two MAC value is equal, then the receiver is sure that there is no alteration in the original message. If these two MAC value are different, then the receiver sure that there is some alteration in the original message. Now look at here. This is the message which is actually transmitted over the network. Now if some attacker takes this message from the network and wants to generate the original message from this message, then the receiver first of all take this message, encrypted message, that is EK2M. From this, if the attacker wants to generate the original message, first of all the attacker must have to know about this K2, because for decrypting this encrypted message a secret key is needed, that is K2. But here this K2 is only known to our sender and receiver. Other than the sender A and receiver B, no one knows this K2. That means here the attacker cannot decrypt this message. So that in this case it satisfies confidentiality. Now next, check for the authenticity. Now look at here. Here the MAC value is calculated from the encrypted message. Here the encrypted message is nothing but that is our ciphertext. That means here our authentication is tied to our ciphertext. This is the case where authentication tied to ciphertext. That means after encrypting the original message, then we calculate the MAC value. Here the MAC value is act as authenticator, so that this case also satisfies the authentication. But the difference between the previous case and in this case is that here we use the encryption directly with our plain text, and after encrypting the plain text, then we calculate the MAC value from our ciphertext. But in our previous case, first we generate the MAC value from our original message, then we append with this MAC value with our plain text. After that we use the encryption algorithm, so that in the previous case the authentication is tied to the plain text, and in this case the authentication is tied to our ciphertext. This is all about the message authentication code, which is the second technique of our authentication. Then in my next lecture I will discuss about the third technique, that is the hash function. How hash function is used for authentication. If you have any doubt regarding this lecture, then you can ask me through comment. I will reply you and discuss about your doubt. Thank you for watching.